That in the previous classes, that is multi-level inverter concept. So in the multi-level inverter, so what we are having two types of, that is single DC source and multiple DC source. Okay, so in the single DC source we are having two types, one is neutral point clamp and another is a flying capacitor. Okay, so rare cases we are using the neutral point clamp. Okay, so flying capacitors having the number of capacitors is high in the flying capacitor. Now coming to the multiple DC sources. So multiple DC sources which have used for in the solar power plant. Okay, so in the solar power plant we having different types of DC sources. Okay, for DC sources which will be having the, so in the solar power plant we are getting the voltage, DC voltage from different sources. That is we are having the different types of the solars, right? So in the solar power plant we are getting the different number of sources. At this instance, so we are using the cascade H type bridge. Okay, that is a multiple DC sources, multiple inverter. In that one, we have the cascade H type bridge we are using. Okay, again in the H bridge. Okay, so based upon the, so how it is a, okay, so in having it is classified in again two types. One is equal DC sources, another is the unequal DC source. So if it is equal DC source is there, okay, that is having the all equal. Okay, so whatever the source, okay, H bridge, so that will be having the equal DC source in each bridge. Okay, and another one that having the unequal DC source, which having in the each bridge that is having the different DC sources. Okay, one is having the 3, one is having the 2, another is like the 1. Okay, in this way, and the equal DC sources, that is having the all bridges having the equal DC sources. Okay, let me see you in the another slide. Here is a neutral point. Okay, here is a neutral point clamp. So in the neutral point clamp multi-level inverter. Okay, so it will be, so in this way, so in the previous, that is a three level inverter. Okay, that will be discussed. So that will have the DC source, single DC source will having, and here having the capacitors. Okay, so that is a VD, so the voltage is blocking at in the DC. Okay, in the capacitor, that is voltage is divided into two equal. Okay, so here having the VDC by, okay, and having another VDS. Okay, so the voltage, whatever the voltage is, that is distributed into two type, and the switch. So here we are using as a switch, as a, that is a power electronic device that will be switched into one different level. That is, it will be connected to the positive one side, another one is connected to neutral. Okay, so here are the neutral point. Okay, we'll consider that 1, 2, 3 points. Okay, so each switch, so one is at the edge time. So point, okay, the switch, it will be, that is here switching is nothing but switch is nothing but it is a one power electronic. So it may be IGBT, okay, or thyristor control, whatever. Okay, so that we are considered as a switch. So whenever the switch is connected, that is whenever the switch is there, okay, it will connect the first one. So what will happen, it will get in the positive, okay, and will give into the load side. And if it connect to the number 2, okay, point 2, so the voltage will have getting, that is a neutral, that is will getting the 0 volt. Okay, how it will be varying, so the voltage will be, and if connected the third point, the voltage will have getting the negative term. Okay, so here we can see that is a 1 2. So when we switching is take place from 1 to 2, so what we are getting, so we are getting the positive. Okay, for phase, that is will getting the VDC by. For if you getting the 3 to 1, so when the switch is coming to the from 1 to 2, okay, so at switch 1, sir, it will be goes to the, that is 1 to 2, what will happen, we getting the positive. When if coming to the 1 to 3, okay, that is the 3 to 1, at the changes, okay, what will happen, getting the total negative volt, right? For 2 to 1, so whenever the changes take places, okay, so from 2 to 1, what will getting, so we are getting the negative VDC by. Okay, from 2 to 3, okay, voltage, so from 0.2 to 0.3, so if it is varies, so what we are getting, we are getting the positive VDC by. Okay, so it will be vary with the voltage. Okay, the voltage, it is varying in this way, so that is positive. Okay, so positive VDC, then it will goes to the 0, and it will get in again negative, and I will give to the, it will goes to the, okay, positive leads to then 0, then positive. So in this way, it will be changes the voltage. Okay, so that is a three step. In the stepped manner it will. So it is the symmetrical, that is in the as alternating way it will be. Okay, so that is what called as a, there is a multi-level curve. Okay, so it will be the stepped waveform will be there. Okay, so in the by using the PWM technique, so we are getting that is a in the sine wave. So here what we are having, so if number of steps if increase it, okay, though it will be getting as a spew sine wave. Okay, this is the example for the single DC source. Okay, so if it is having the in the previous step, so that will be shown in a for three level. Now it will be shown in this one. Okay, here this is whatever the switching is there. Okay, that will be showing in by using the different thyristor. So we are in the transistor switching. Okay, so how it will be power electronic devices are there. Okay, you can see, so this is the one three phase one. Okay, so three phase diode clamp converter, multi-level converter, so that is nothing but a neutral point plant. Okay, diode clamp or neutral point, so both are same. So we can in this some case it will be termed as a neutral point, so some case it will be considered as a diode clamp. So based upon, so why it will be called as diode clamp, so for each in each switches, okay, we are having the ant, okay, that will be connected, that is a one diodes will be connected in each switches. Okay, that's why it's called as a diode clamp. Okay, and it will be connected with the neutral. Okay, that's why it's called as a neutral clamp also. Okay, for each phase that is connected to the neutral. So here we having the, so in the single DC source and we are having the different capacitors. So in this diagram you can see the, so different, so this is the three phase. So for each phase, so this for each phase, okay, this is phase, so this one is called as a one leg. Okay, this is a one leg operation. So this is a, we have the three legs, that is a, for three phases we have the three legs up. So in each leg we have the different operations. So in the previous, so we have seen that, so only switching, so in the past you two, so that is where stated in the, so one, okay, neutral as a two, and another points as considered as a three point. Okay, so switching is varies from 1 to 2 and 2 to 3. Okay, so here how it is switching is varied. Okay, that will be explained here. Okay, so I'm here, this the about the one I'm showing, that is the diagram how it will be looking in the diode clamp. So here in this diagram, okay, how it is operations take places. Okay, so for one for different points, that is 1, 2, 3 points come. Okay, so from one point how it will be there. Okay, at the point two how it is be connected, at the point three how it is connected. Okay, so here we can see that for one leg, so for one leg operation, so here having the, we are having the transistor along with the diodes. So we having the S1 S2 S3 S4. Okay, we are connecting as a S1 S2, and we are having the diodes D1 D2. Okay, you can see in diodes, right? So these are the diodes, that's it called as a diode clamped. Okay, diode clamped multi-level inverter. Okay, so here we are in at the first instance, so for first instance, so we are considering the for phase A. Okay, for phase A, so in the past volt, so when the switching is take places, so for one, okay, for one, so at this instance what will happen, the voltage, okay, the current waveform you can see, so it will switching is take places from this one. So that is the S1 S2 are the connected switching and will goes to the phase and neutral. Okay, so this one, so how it will be voltage is generated. Okay, you can see in this diagram, so that is in the positive way that voltage is increased. Now after that, so it will switching, okay, at next one what happened, the switching, so after switching that is connect to the second point, so what will happen, it will connect to the neutral. So at neutral what happened, it will be in a closer, so that why, so voltage will having the zero. Okay, at this stand what happened, the voltage is produced, that is zero voltage is produced. Next after another instant, that is a here third state. So in the third state what will happen, that will be connected to the negative VDC. So you can see this is the positive, here having the negative, that is in third state will connect to the negative. The voltage, that is the S3 and S4 are the switching is taken, that's you are getting the negative VDC. Okay, so we are getting the negative, so this is the three phase. For this is the three level multiple current. that is at one stand, so what we'll getting positive VDC. So another instant that if we connect to the second prime, that is a neutral, so we're getting the zero voltage. Okay, but that can connect to the negative, so we'll getting the negative VDC. So that is how it is a single leg operations take place. Okay, this is the single for three level inverter. Okay, for this is for single phase. Okay, so that's nothing but is that we are considering that is a one leg operation. Okay, for one leg operation, so how it is the voltage is varies, that will be in the multi-level. Okay, that is be in this having the capacitor clamp. Okay, in the previous we have seen, so diode clamp are nothing but neutral clamp. Now it will be having the capacitor clamp. So how it will be having, whole diagram will be represented. Okay, capacitor clamp multi-level inverter. Okay, so in the capacitor clamp, so we having the single DC source. Okay, so we are having the single DC sources and we're having the two VDCs, that is nothing but capacitor, and along with the switching capability. Okay, when the switching is there, okay, that will having the here flying capacitor. So we having these are called as a flying capacitor. Okay, that will be connected in the whenever the switching is there. Okay, for having the capacitor will be there. So in between, after the switching, after operation, that will be connected at the one capacitors. Okay, that's well called as a flying capacitor. So here we can see in this diagram, so is the how it is a switching is take place in this diagram, you can see. Okay, so for three level flying capacitor, okay, with the SPDTs configuration. Okay, single pole double throw switch. Okay, and the configuration of SPDT. So in this diagram you can see the three level flying capacitor. Okay, so here we have the transistor along with the, so you can see here having the this one, the switching capacity. Okay, so here we are having the power electronic devices along with the when our switching is take place. Okay, that is connected, and we are having the flying capacitor, how it is it connect. So whenever the switching is there, okay, you can see the switching, when the switching close on off. Okay, stated. So you can see the variations also, voltage current variations all been done at this one, and the voltage. Okay, the voltage parameters and current parameter. Okay, that will be controlled by in this. Okay, capacitor, that is the flying capacitor also there, and the diode clamp method. So what we are using, so we are using as a diodes as a without getting the short circuit. Here also we are using to short circuit or protection of the equipment. So what we are using, flying capacitors are. Okay, that's why its name is the capacitor clamp. Okay, so neutral point clamp. So in that one, so what we are using at the instant, so neutral point. So what we are using, diodes are. So here we are using the capacitor, that's why it has a capacitor clamp. So if you're using the diodes, that will be act, that will name as a diode clamp. So if you're using the capacitor, that will name. So here in this diagram you can see the how is the flying capacitor clamp diagram, as you can see. Okay, so here I'm the circuit diagram. So here is the single DC source and how is the each leg. Okay, how capacitor is connected. So you can see that in the previous state, so the capacitor. Okay, so whatever the capacitor is there, so neutral point, we here don't have any neutral clamp, so that will combine with the capacitor. Okay, so that is eliminated with the capacitors. You can serve each leg that is connected to the, to avoid the short circuit, we are getting the here capacitor. So each leg you can see here is the capacitor, right? So they are different. So if you're using neutral clamp, so that will be connected the neutral and along with the diode. But here flying capacitor, so we are getting the avoid short circuiting operation. So here using as a capacitor, that's its name is come to the flying capacitor or capacitor clamp multi-level inverter. Okay, so these are the about the